A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 1st October. On the front page you have Kerala tops education ranking. So this is Niti Aayog's school education quality index. Here in this ranking, Kerala is on number 1 and Uttar Pradesh is at the bottom. So it's Kerala and Rajasthan have emerged as states with the best quality of school education in the country, with scores of 76.6% and 72.9% respectively. So this is Niti Aayog's ranking. Among union territories also, Chandigarh actually has scored over 80%. Then this is, only 4 juveniles have been detained after August 5 in Jammu and Kashmir. So following Supreme Court's direction, High Court judge visited observation home and has seen that only 4 boys below the age of 18 years were detained by the police, and they are now lodged at a juvenile observation home in Srinagar as such. So it is said in all there are 21 boys at the observation home. 17 were detained before 5th August, and High Court says there are only 4 who have been detained after 5th August. Then this is 8 core sectors shrink 0.5% in August. So, under IIP, Index of Industrial Production, there are 8 core sectors. So, here the ranking, here the growth in 8 core sectors, you can see, is not there. They have shrunk rather. Then below you have, Supreme Court pulls up Gujarat for not paying Bilquees Banu. So, this is 2002 Gujarat riots victim, who the Supreme Court had ordered that the Gujarat government should pay 50 lakh in compensation, a house and a job, to tide over the devastation of her family. She was, you can see the detail given here. It was Supreme Court of 5 months ago gave this order. The tragedy of Ms. Banu, it was her infant daughter was smashed against the wall in their house before her own eyes, and she was herself pregnant when she was gang raped. And 7 members of her family were also killed by a mob as such. So government, when the Solicitor General was questioned by the Supreme Court why the government has not paid 5 months since the order, it is responded saying that the government is planning to file a review petition in this case. Then here you have, scientists excavate ancient river in Uttar Pradesh. So this is the paleo channel linked as such, which links the Ganga and the Yamuna near Prayagraj. So scientists have discovered this ancient buried river that links Ganga and Yamuna. You can see, so this is Ganga river, the Yamuna river, and this is a discovered ancient river. So Union Water Ministry has excavated this old dried up river in Prayagraj, that is former Allahabad. Then on page 9 you have, floods in many parts of Bihar, Uttar Pradesh. So monsoon season officially ended on Monday, but several parts of Bihar and Uttar Pradesh are reeling from floods following incessant showers over the past few days. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Dangerous Precedent. So this is regarding Election Commission's order on Sikkim CM's disqualification. It goes against the anti-graft current in law. So, anti-corruption law, which is there, the point which is there, that is being violated by this Election Commission's order, which also is without any proposal from the Sikkim CM himself, from the candidate himself. And Election Commission has reviewed and reduced his disqualification term from 6 years to just 1 year, 1 month, and allowed him to become Sikkim Chief Minister. So, this is said to be a dangerous precedent. And this is testing time. So this is how India plays South Africa in cricket. So this is regarding ICC World Test Championship. So how India has a chance to strengthen its test position now, it's discussed, which is not relevant for UPSC. And this is the link between jobs, farming and climate. So it says it is imperative to focus on agricultural production in devising a long-term solution to the problem of employment. So, how can jobs, farming and climate be linked is detailed out here. So, agricultural production should be focused on. So, that, you know, if that is the focus, agriculture is the focus, then unemployment problem can also be solved jobs can be generated here in the farming sector, and even climate resilience and farming in a way that is not harmful to the environment can be promoted. And this is a test for judicial review in India. So UK Supreme Court ruled on parliament prorogation, Boris Johnson, when he prorogued the parliament. So this step of UK Supreme Court is said to be an exemplar on how judiciary should view executive actions, and it calls it a test for judicial review in India. On page 11 you have creating jobs for young India. So it says, if India does not make effective use of the strengths of its youths now, it may never will. So we have a huge demographic dividend, but if they are not given jobs, if and we don't make effective use of it, then it will be a liability rather than an asset. And this is housing crisis untouched. So this is regarding draft Model Tenancy Act. It says it does little to address current issues in the rental housing market. So problems with the draft Model Tenancy Act of 2019, which was released by Ministry of Housing in July, is detailed out here. On page 13, you have this news regarding Jammu and Kashmir, which we've already covered, regarding Block Development Council elections and the shutdown. Also, the case would be heard. So we'll discuss when the statute bench hears the case. And this is green energy target lacks deadline. So this is regarding how there is no fixed year for increase of share of non-fossil fuels to 450 gigawatts, as the Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced that renewable energy target would be increased, but then there is no deadline set for it. So that point is raised here. Even on single-use plastic, it has been reiterated there would be no ban on single-use plastic from 2nd October, the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. But then states have been asked to restrict the use of this class of plastic. Then on international page you have both Ghani Abdullah claim lead in Afghanistan elections. So Afghan presidential elections took place, and both Afghanistan's chief executive Abdullah Abdullah claimed victory over incumbent Ashraf Ghani in the presidential elections. So now political tensions may rise. Mr. Ghani and Mr. Abdullah are top rivals, and they bitterly contested in 2014 also, which sparked a constitutional crisis and prompted US intervention. So now again, you can see, according to information, 60-70% of the people have voted for Mr. Abdullah, and he claimed victory. So results will be announced. We should rather cover the news when the actual final results are announced by the Election Commission. And this is Austria's Kurz faces tricky choice to form next government. So this is former Chancellor of Austria, Sebastian Kurz. He is set to return to power after his Conservative People's Party came first in the parliamentary elections. But he doesn't have majority to form the government. So he'll have to form coalition and others as such. He said it seems it is a tough choice. He'll have to explore the possibility of a coalition. On business page you have current account deficit shrinks. So RBI data shows that current account deficit narrowed to 2% of GDP in first quarter of financial year 2019-20. From 2.3% in previous first quarter. And this is what the front page news also spoke of. Core sector growth slips to 52 month low. So 5 out of 8 sectors in the 8 core sectors are in negative zone. So serious cause of concern. And this is regarding states cross fiscal deficit stayed within 3%. So RBI says that states fiscal deficits are within the limit set by Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act threshold of 3%. And this is government to borrow 2.68 lakh crores in October to March. So in the second quarter now, government has plans to borrow 2.68 lakh crores. So its target borrowing was 4.42 lakh crores in the first half of the financial year, and it will borrow more now. So the government is maintaining its glide path to meet the fiscal deficit target of 3.3%. It is a cause of concern again. Then on the last page you have sports news. So that is it. These were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.